English Yari is the most affordable platform for improving your English speaking.
Oh my God, I think you are an all-rounder, isn't it?
Yeah, maybe.
What would you do if you were a billionaire? How would you spend the money?
Mom always lectures me that it's tough to earn money. Once I get a job, then only I'll understand the value. I haven't thought about that. Maybe of like any brand or maybe a hotel chain. They lost their job. So I would say that nothing is secure. You are going to have some ups and downs in your life. They are just, we have to take risks because those ups and downs will be there in your life. So I think that's why business are a little better. I had butterflies in my stomach.
That's a nice one. Okay, you could say I had ants in my pants. He had a new lease on life.
Okay.
How are you?
Hello, I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm great too. I see a beautiful library behind you. Do you love
reading? Yeah, I love reading.
That's great. They look lovely. What's your favorite book?
I usually love to read Harry Potter series, but nowadays I'm also reading the Geronimo Stilton series.
Oh, all right. I'm planning to buy a set of Harry Potter now.
Okay, but the main thing with Harry Potter is that you have to be very patient because those books are like very thick and they're very long.
Yeah, I'm aware. And I am quite, you know, I have a short attention span. So I specifically need to be, you know, aware of that. All right. And all right, Arundhati. So, you know, before we start the class, let me tell you about myself. Okay.
Okay.
So I'm Tanya and I have a master's degree in English literature from the University of Delhi. And also, you know, I work internationally as well as nationally. I teach English all around the world. All right. So different kinds, different people. And I've been teaching for around, you could say, 5 years. All right.
Oh, wow.
Yes. So could you tell me about yourself?
Okay, so I'm Arundhati Roktama. I live in Bhilai. It's a small city in Chhattisgarh. It's in the central part of India. And I'm 12 years old. I study in class 7th. And I study in Delhi Public School, Bhilai. And my hobbies are coding. I love to make apps and websites, all those things. And singing. I also love singing and reading books. I also love dancing.
You do. Oh my God, I think you are an all-rounder, isn't it?
Yeah, maybe.
Perfect. So Arundhati, did you go through the, you know, PDF that was given to you?
Yeah, I went through it.
Okay, perfect. So what would you do if you were a billionaire? How would you spend the money?
Okay, so I think that it's a very good question. Because as I think that all the people are after money. We need money for our livelihood and for our luxuries. So if I get $1 million or like a lot of money, so I would be very happy. You know, the middle class people have this one problem that we have the crunch of money. My mom always lectures me that it's tough to earn money. Once I get a job, then only I'll understand the value of money. So if I get a great amount of money, so I will first fulfill my basic needs. That is good food, good clothes, maybe branded, and a good house. And once I get all these things, then I would love to go for my luxuries. I would love to live a great, lavish life. I would spend on some brandly, costly accessories, like my these glasses. They cost me 13K. So my mom always says me to my mom always tells me to take care of these. It should not be broken at any cost. So I would love to have some great cars like BMW or Mercedes, and I would love to have a very big mansion like with many rooms. So yeah, I would also love to go on a world tour. I love to visit many countries because I love to learn the culture of different countries. So yeah, I would love to go for a world tour. And yeah, I would live a great life. And one thing I would also like to do, that I would love to go to a concert of my favorite singer, because the concert tickets, they cost near about $200, which is, I guess, 14,000 rupees. So yeah, I would love to go for a concert of my favorite singer.
Who is your favorite singer?
Taylor Swift.
Oh, all right. Well, she is a really nice personality also.
Yeah.
Apart from, you know, being a great singer. So, you know, you talked about having a lot of things, but you know what the main deal is? People, when they get money, they just spend all the money in, we could say, upgrading their lifestyle, and at the end, left with none. Would you like to be that person?
No. First, I would love to go for a little bit of the lavish life. Then I would make my like a stable business maybe, or be something in my life that would give me some money. Means like a job or maybe a business, like a big business or something. So yeah, for that, I would love to settle first so that the income is just like a stable throughout my life. So yeah.
You could say, you know, I want a sustainable business source, right?
Yeah.
Sustainable income. Yes, that's right. Okay. And, you know, since you talked about being a businesswoman or an entrepreneur, what kind of business would you like to do?
I haven't thought about that. Maybe of like any brand or maybe a hotel chain, maybe.
I see. Well, I think you are really going to be rich.
Oh.
Well, you know, the thing is, you know, all our family members tell us to go for a job and get some money. But just by getting a job, I think we only live a mediocre life.
Yeah.
Amazing one. What's your take on it?
Yeah, you're right. Because if we are in a job, we are just means we are there's not much of a freedom in what we can do. If we have a job, then we'll have to means agree with our boss's orders and all those things. We would not have the freedom to make our own choices in our work or our own decisions. So yeah, I would think that jobs, if you're in a job, you won't be able to live like a very different type of life, not a free life. You would be like in a cage maybe.
Yeah, oh my God, you understand me. Well, you know, a lot of people still go for jobs because I think they are made to believe that this is the only right one and the secure one. So they prefer that still, right?
Yeah, jobs are definitely secure. But as we have seen in this COVID times, many people lost their jobs. Even though those jobs were like secure for the past years, but during this pandemic, they lost their jobs. So I would say that nothing is secure. You are going to have some ups and downs in your life. They are just, we have to take risks because those ups and downs will be there in your life. So I think that's why business are a little better, because in that you can, you'll be able to grow and you will have the freedom to make your own decisions, your own choices about your work. So yeah.
Yeah, and you know, as an employee, you only have certain limitations that you you can't grow after a certain time or certain amount of time. But as an entrepreneur, you always need to upgrade, you know, at a certain place or at a certain time. And it's not just about being rich, right? Because Jeff Bezos, look at Elon Musk, they are, you know, they are rich, but they are not just living a luxurious life. That's not about it. They are putting in their resources to help the economy, to help their country. Correct. Okay. Never mind. All right. So, could you tell me about some demerits of being a billionaire?
Okay. So, I think there are a few demerits as well. Although there are some good things, but there are some demerits. That is, like rich people, they start thinking that they are the greatest person there. They get a little bit of ego. Their nature just gets changed. They have this great pride of themselves. They get this bossy type of behavior. And they think that they are the best people, and they stop helping poor people. They just lose their control and they think that they can do anything with money. And sometimes there can be some issues with their relationships as well. And I have seen that many rich people, there is less humbleness and politeness in them. But I've always seen that Bill Gates, he's a billionaire, and he has his own foundation to help people. And I always want to be like them. I want to be down to earth.
Yeah. Even the person I like the most are Obama and Obama, they're really nice and kind people, right? Okay. So, you know, when you said that, you know, they think about money all the time and they become kind of egoistic, you could just say money, you know, gets to their head. And they become indifferent to poor people, or you could also say they become, they turn their ear around. I think that's what it's called, you know, turning your ear opposite to someone or something. And then there's this thing, down to earth. I think you already know that, right?
They're
down to earth. Yes. So these are the things that happens. And also, you know, for me, the demerits of being a billionaire, I know I won't, you know, I won't be all egoistic if I have money. But the biggest demerits are, like, I think there would be some difficulties for me regarding, you know, security, because billionaires need a lot of security. They always need to think, oh, is someone coming in? Okay, is someone trying to kidnap my kid or my family, or, you know, being interfering?
That fear is always there with rich people.
Right, and they absolutely lose their privacy. My privacy is very important to me. I don't want to wait. So the thing is, I want to be a billionaire, but a secret one.
Oh yeah, that's a really nice thing, to be like a secret billionaire.
Right. All right. And do you have any questions? Do you have any questions that you would like to ask?
No.
None? All right.